What's cooking, everybody? It's Thor, and in this video we will be taking a closer look at the derelict freighter salvage building parts in No Man's Sky. We will of course be taking a look on how to unlock all the building parts, as well as the burning parts itself, and of course take a look at one of the best building parts you can get, the emergency heater. And so without any further ado, let's get straight into it. So to be able to unlock the derelict freighter salvage base building parts, you will of course need to go to a derelict freighter. To do this, you can head up to a scrap dealer aboard the space station and acquire coordinates. This will give you an emergency broadcast receiver, which you can use to find a derelict freighter. Alternatively, if you have already completed the derelict freighter, you can get one for free at Iteration Helios every week. So I would definitely advise on taking this opportunity, as these emergency broadcast receivers are quite expensive. If you have an emergency broadcast receiver, you will want to fly out into space and select Tune Signal. You will then have to pulse with your starship until you receive the message that an emergency broadcast is detected. Once you exit the pulse, you should see a derelict freighter. Fly towards it and land on it. If you want to know everything about derelict freighters, I have a guide just for you, which I'll link in the description down below. I will go over it briefly though. Derelict freighters consist of multiple rooms. In these rooms you can encounter enemies, but you will also most definitely encounter collectibles. You have these floating around, which will give you oxygen and sodium, but you also have these large crates, which can give you any kind of materials, but also, most importantly, the base building parts we're after. You will also find these emergency heaters scattered across, which will keep you warm and make sure you won't die. I would say that on average I got 1 to 2 building parts per freighter I visited. Just make sure to interact and open all the crates aboard the derelict freighter, as this will minimize you skipping one of these building parts altogether. There are a total of 15 of these derelict freighter salvage base building parts, so it will take you a maximum of 15 derelict freighters to complete to receive them all. If you're also interested in upgrading your own freighter fully, you will also want to do this derelict freighter, since you will get the upgrade modules from this and also the ability to expand your storage. If you want to know more on this and want to know the perfect placement for all your tags in your freighter for the best adjacency bonuses, I will also link that video in the description down below. So now you know how to unlock the base building parts, let's have a look at them. You can find the derelict freighter salvage base building parts under the furnishing tab in your build menu. If you scroll all the way down, you'll see them right there. Now it is worth noting that all these base building parts can be adjusted in size. In this example, the industrial pallet, which costs 5 pure ferrite to place down. All these base building parts should look familiar to you, as they are all based on the parts you'll find on derelict freighters themselves. For example, the crew locker, which costs 5 pure ferrite to place down. Once placed, you can open and close it just like you would on derelict freighters, but of course, unfortunately, it will not give you anything in return. Same goes for the crew footlocker, which also costs 5 pure ferrite. The industrial barrel, which also costs 5 pure ferrite, is just a decorative item though. It doesn't have any function or feature at all. Same goes for the industrial bench, which also costs 5 pure ferrite. I really think Halo Games dropped the ball here. It would be a very nice bench to place down if you were be able to sit on it. The heavy duty furniture also costs 5 pure ferrite, and you are able to place the crates on the shelves just like they are presented on derelict freighters, so that's pretty cool. Especially if you want to create a storage room or anything on your base, these are a must have. The secure briefcase, which also costs 5 pure ferrite, can also be opened and closed. Then you have the large storage unit, which costs 15 pure ferrite, which is also just a decorative item. And of course, a smaller variant of it for 10 pure ferrite. Then for 10 condensed carbon, you can place down the canister rack. Also a brilliant decorative item for any storage room. You can place down the sample containment for 10 silver and 1 larval core. This is a container featuring one of the crawlers, which you can also encounter on a derelict freighter. It's been held in place and you can see its eye moving if you look closely. You can also place down a floral canister for 10 silver and 10 condensed carbon, and these also resemble the ones found on derelict freighters. So that were all the decorative items you can unlock on derelict freighters. We have two more items to discuss, which are very useful in base building, if I say so myself. So before I continue, I would want to ask you to please leave a thumbs up if you liked the video, let me know in the comments down below what you did most, and please subscribe to see more No Man's Sky content in the future. The first one is the emergency light. It costs 5 pure ferrite and 50 sodium to place down. It's the lights that are used mostly on derelict freighters, and it's one of the best light sources in game if you ask me. It does give this spooky foggy kind of light though, so that's something to bear in mind. As well as the fact that the light source generated from this lamp also scales with the size of the lamp itself. So you can play around by resizing these, and you'll also see that the light bundle will resize with it as well. And then lastly, we have the emergency heater, which costs 10 gold and 10 pure ferrite. As derelict freighters are very cold, these are scattered around to keep you warm and keep you alive. But this also works on your bases as well, and not even only on cold climates, but on every climate. As you can see here in this example, I'm in a superheated storm on my base, and if I turn on the heating unit itself, my shield will stop draining and it will fill up again as well. Now it is worth noting that if you actually change the size of the emergency heater, you will also change the radius in which it is effective. So in this example you can see that I'm still protected from the heat while standing a few meters away from this enlarged emergency heater. If you compare this to the normal emergency heater, I would say that its range of effect is only about a meter around the pillar itself. Of course, this also means if you make them smaller, and that really goes to really tiny as well, that the effective range will also shrink down. So as I said, you can literally use the emergency heater to protect you from any environment. The funny thing about this is that it even works underwater. Though I have personally not tested this if it would also work in space. Finally, I would like to add that unfortunately most of these items are not recolorable, and the items that do allow you to recolor it also do so on certain parts of the item and not the entirety of the item itself. And that was all for this video. Have you already snacked up all the derelict freighter salvage base building parts, or are you still missing some? Let me know in the comments down below, and I hope to see you in the next one.